Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we're making the Taiwanese Shacha prawn. This is a very simple and fast recipe that only takes you around 5 minutes to cook. And on top of that, I'm also gonna teach you how to clean up a whole prawn from this to this. Check it out. Hey friends, this is Erica right here. I'm a Taiwanese citizen currently living in America. Cooking and traveling are my passions, so I'm here to share a few of my favorite Asian recipes. On top of that, I also make videos talking about food knowledge and a history background after this on this channel, so if that interests you, please subscribe and keep watching. In most of the Western cuisine, you will not see a whole animal part on the dining table, so you can enjoy your food without feeling guilty about killing an animal. But if you really think about it, that creates a lot of food waste. Using chicken as example, everybody wants chicken wing, drumstick, and the breast. But have you ever think about where the rest of the chicken goes? In the old Chinese culture, we trash our food source to an extent. So we like to cook our animal in whole, kind of like your Thanksgiving that you cook a whole turkey instead of only turkey breasts. This not only creates less food waste, it also gave you opportunity to realize how good pig ears and chicken feet taste. Relax, we're not going so hardcore today, but we'll start with something very simple, cooking a whole prawn. Moving here to the US, I realized if you go to a normal grocery store, most of the prawn and shrimp you find there will be without head. But if you had the opportunity to get your hands on some head-on prawn, you will realize when you're cooking it how much better it tastes and smells. So today, I'm gonna teach you how to clean and prep a whole prawn that can keep most of its flavor and also look pleasant. So, screenshot! Here are the ingredients that we'll need for today's recipe. We need around 10 prawn, some oil, garlic, scallion, and basil. For the seasoning, we'll need some shacha sauce, some oyster sauce, cooking rice wine, and some curry powder. Finding fresh prawn is the most important step in this recipe. If you didn't know, 99% of the prawn that we got in the grocery store are actually frozen. Even those ones that you see in a seafood counter. You might feel deceived a little bit, just like the first time I figured that out. But the truth is, frozen is actually the best way to keep seafood fresh. Now, when it comes to actually how to pick the fresh prawn, I have made a video talking about it before, so I'll put a link up here for you if you're interested. The recipe today is very simple, so we're gonna put our focus on how to clean up a whole prawn. After you bring your prawn home, the first thing you wanna do is wash them thoroughly and prepare a scissor, and then we can start to prep. When cooking a whole prawn, we want to keep as much part as possible to keep its flavor, but also take up the part that is not edible. Things like their tiny legs, claws, mouth, and eyes are way too tiny to consume. So we'll be cutting them off. You want to aim almost at the center of the prawn's head right below its eyes and cut off that tip. Next, cut off all of its legs from head to toe for easier execution. If you do it another way around, it will be a little bit harder. Next step, we want to open its back. Put your scissor in from the back of the prawn right behind the head shell and then gently cut all the way to its tail. We're doing this for two different reasons. First, we all know that shrimp and prawn have the vein in the back, so if we cut it open, it's easier to take them out. There are also other ways to take out the veins without cutting the back open. I have done that before in the explain video. You can check that out. But there's a second reason why we want to cut the back open is to let the prawn absorb more of the flavoring later. Since we're cooking the prawn with shelf on today, cutting the back open can allow the seasoning go straight into the meat. After you cut them open, you can take out the vein by pulling a little bit, or you can also wash them off in water. When you're done with all of them, use a paper towel to pat them dry gently. Because if you don't do so, the oil splash it creates will burn you very easily later. Now you know how to clean up your prawn, let's mix up our sauce. We're making shacha shrimp, so there's definitely some shacha. And for the umami, we'll be adding some oyster sauce. Water it down with some cooking rice wine, which can also cover the seafood gaminess. Then add in some curry powder, because curry and shacha goes really well together always. Mix them well and add more cooking wine if needed to create this consistency. And we're ready to cook! Seafood contains a lot of water, so when we're trying to sear them, a lot of time there will be oil splash. So that's why in our previous video, I introduced you these oil splash nets that can prevent yourself from getting burned. You might think, why don't I just use a lid instead of this? Because lid will create a steaming environment. When you use a net like this, it will trap the oil inside the pot, but also let the steam out. But if you don't have one, you can always just stay far away from your pot. Heat up your wok and add in some oil. To make this process faster and easier, you can line up the prawn to the shape of your pan on a plate first, so that we can slide them in whole and run away from burning. Wait till the oil is hot, slide in your prawn from the plate and cover. Now, while the net is covering the splash but still letting the steam out, we can reach a tong in it and rearrange them real quick. You wanna make sure all of the prawn are touching the wok directly. As soon as the splashing stops, you can remove the net or leave it on if you hate cleaning up the stove like me. Depending on your cookware, it is a little bit hard to tell you exactly how much time you need to sear your prawn, but you can have a pretty good idea by looking at its color. As soon as you see all the prawn has turned orange on one side, you can one by one flip them over. You might find it a little bit hard to line them up perfectly again because when the protein of your prawn slowly being cooked through, it will start to harden and roll up. But as long as all of them are touching the wok directly, we're good. It doesn't have to be pretty right here. Now, while they're cooking, we're adding in our scallion and garlic slices. Try your best to let these herbs max out their flavor by coming in contact with the hot oil directly without moving our prawn too much. When you see that the back of the shrimp start opening up and has all turned white from gray, you can turn the heat to low and add in your sauce mix. Simply mixing the sauce with all of your ingredients with a spatula and let them absorb the flavor for at least 90 seconds. Before plating, we'll splash some cooking wine from the side of a wok to create some aroma, and you can add in your basil. Mix, 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 turn up the heat, and done! The Shacha prawn is ready. Oh, it smells so good. Is it obvious that I'm a Shacha addict? The flavor combination of Shacha and curry are excellent, and the prawn is cooked to perfection. These strong flavor prawn recipe are best paired with a bowl of rice, and you can also pair them with some beer if you want. Enjoy! Thank you for cooking with me to the end. Let me know if you like this recipe by giving this video a thumbs up. It's only gonna take you a second, but it means a lot to me. I make kitchen trivia short and Asian home cooking recipe on this channel every Monday and Thursday, so remember to hit that bell and you'll never miss out. Here's an explain video talking all about shrimp, and there's another video about Shacha recipe right here for you. Last but not least, don't forget to subscribe on my channel if you haven't already, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!